Sean, how do you balance all the discussion on the historical importance of this fight with just preparing for this one fight with your opponent ahead of you?
It comes with the territory, you know, and that's why I say I'm excited to be on CBS and for it to be on prime time and, you know, being a part of history, you know. So, like he said, you acknowledge it, but you don't, you know, I'm not going to allow it, you know, the importance or the significance of this fight to, you know, override my energy and my mindset going into the fight or anything like that. I'm humbled, you know, that to be the first fight on CBS since, you know, a Muhammad Ali fight. That's awesome, you know. But, you know, I don't, even, you know, being exciting is never a concern of mine because as long as I'm performing and doing what I'm supposed to do, the fight will be exciting. You know, I have a saying, I don't condone boos. You know, as long as I'm fighting, you will never boo. You'll never be bored or anything like that. So it's awesome. You know, I love it. I think it's going to add to my level of excitement and my positiveness going into the fight, but it won't get me, you know, overexcited or anything like that.
I know I've asked you a couple of times, but can you just talk about just how big of a legacy that you need this so that when you hang up the gloves, how big would this fight be in your legacy when it's all said and done in a big stack of things?
Yeah, this fight has been in my mind for a number of years, you know, and I've said this before, you know, looking at our careers and the way that they were moving, and both of us being at 147, Keith being as dominant as he has been, I knew that this was going to, you know, this fight would happen eventually. And it was a fight that I wanted to happen, you know. I'm all about, you know, beating the guy that is considered the guy. I'm all about being the number one. You know, I love having all eyes on me. You guys know me to be very humble, but when I'm in the ring, when I'm performing, when everyone's watching, I want them to be watching me, watching, seeing what I'm doing and screaming my name, you know. So I think knowing what Keith has done and him being the champion, when you beat a champion, you take the belt. That's how you form your legacy. You know, you don't form your legacy from, you know, beating C-level fighters, B-level fighters. You beat those AA-plus fighters and you take their belts, and that's how you establish your greatness.
Well, it'd be safe to say that whoever wins this fight will be the 147 kingpin that throne that Floyd's left, that y'all be the heir to that throne, because y'all basically fight for the number one spot at welterweight.
I mean, if you really take a look at it, we both have the attitude for it. We both have the physicality and the athleticism to be that number one guy. You know, it's just a matter of me getting in there and doing what I got to do.